ॐ सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं कर्वावहै तेजस्विनावतितमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। ओम मे ही प्रोटेक्ट अस बोथ टीचर एंड स्टूडेंट टुगेदर, मे ही नरिश अस बोथ टुगेदर, मे वी वर्क कंजॉइंटली विथ ग्रेट एनर्जी, मे आवर स्टडीज बी विगरस एंड इफेक्टिव, मे वी नॉट म्यूचुअली डिस्प्यूट और मे वी नॉट हेट एनी। ओम लेट देयर बी पीस इन मी, let there be peace in my environment, and let there be peace in the forces that act on me. Proximal humerus fractures. Dear students, we will be discussing on the proximal humerus fractures using following points. 1. Incidence. 2. Mechanism. 3. Classification. 4. Displacing muscle forces. 5. Clinical features. 6. Investigations. 7. Management. And 8. Complications. This is common in elderly patients and it accounts for 4-5% of all the fractures. It is more common in elderly females due to osteoporosis. A fall on an outstretched hand is a typical classical history, as you can see in this particular diagram. And the another mechanism is blow on the lateral side of the arm is another mode of injury. Now Neil has described the four segments with respect to the proximal humerus. You can see these are the four segments: the head, the lesser tuberosity, the greater tuberosity, and the shaft. So the anatomical neck, that whenever there is a fracture here at the anatomical neck, the incidence of avascular necrosis is very high. Wherever the greater tuberosity fracture could happen, the lesser tuberosity fracture could happen, and the surgical neck fracture. Whenever the fracture occurs here, we call it as a surgical neck of the humerus. And here, the incidence of AVN is very, very less. Now, Neil has proposed a classification for the fracture of the proximal humerus based on this four segment concept. Now, this is particular classification he has described. Though before that, let us see various muscle forces acting on the various components of the proximal humerus and causing the fracture displacement. Now, look at this particular diagram. In the greater tuberosity, it is the supraspinatus and the external rotators are attached here, and it leads displaces the fracture segment upwards. To the lesser tuberosity, as you can see here, the subscapularis is inserted and it generates a deforming force and displaces the fracture fragment medially. Now, the shaft gives attachment to the pectoralis major, which causes medial and internal rotation. And anatomical neck has no muscle attachment. Here, hence, if fractured there, the chances of AVN are more, because there will not be any blood supply, source of blood supply to the fractured neck, fractured head of the humerus. Now, these above muscles pull the fracture fragment in different directions, leading to a widespread displacement and angulation. When any of the four major segments is displaced more than 1 centimeter or is angulated more than 45 degree, the fracture is considered displaced. I will repeat it for you. When any of the four major segment is displaced more than 1 centimeter or is angulated more than 45 degree, then that fracture is considered displaced. Now 80% of the fracture displacement is minimal and only 20% of the fracture fragments are displaced. Now there are four major categories as described by the need. Now earlier the number of fracture lines were taken into account to label the proximal humerus fracture as a two part or a three part or a four part fracture. Now it is the number of displaced fragments. We have already defined when do you call it as a displaced fragment. So now the number of displaced fragment is taken into consideration than the earlier number of fracture lines. Now this particular diagram shows how the two part fractures would look like, how the three part fractures will look like, and how the four part fracture will look like. Now thus for the clarity, it can be said that a one part fracture is a fracture with minimal displacement. So there can be a one part fracture as well. Now two part fracture is where one segment is displaced in relation to the other. Now here you can see how the one segment is displaced in relation to other. Here the GT is displaced, here the shaft is displaced, and like that. A three-part fracture is where the two segments are displaced in relation with the other two. Now here you can see the shaft is displaced, GT is displaced, like that. Shaft is displaced, LT is displaced. And for a four-part fracture, where all four major segments are displaced, as shown in this particular diagram. Now these above fractures, when associated with either anterior dislocation or with posterior dislocation of shoulder, they are called as two-part fracture dislocation, three-part fracture dislocation, etc. Now clinically, the patient complains of pain, swelling, and other features of the fracture. Now you can see here the swelling and ecchymosis. The movements of shoulder joint are grossly restricted. Investigation wise, plain x-ray of the shoulder joint, a trauma series consists of AP view, lateral view, axillary view of the shoulder joint in scapular plane. Now this particular thing shows you how you can take the lateral axillary view. The laminogram to judge the articular surfaces defect is also useful. CT scan, 3D reconstruction helps the study of fracture lines with greater accuracy. Coming to the management part, the management of the proximal humerus fracture can be considered under two broad headings. One is non-operative treatment and other is operative treatment. In the non-operative treatment, indications are undisplaced fracture, surgical neck fractures, poor health, poor surgical risk, very old patients, and the conservative treatment consists of rest, NSAIDs, sling, ice and heat therapy in the initial stages, U-slab and rarely U-cast may be required. Now this is what is known as a U-slab or U-cast. It may be required in the fractures with very minimal displacement. Since 80% of the fractures are minimally displaced, early motion of the shoulder is the mainstay of the treatment to prevent stiffness of the shoulder joint. Pendular exercises, elevation, the pulley exercises, the external and internal rotation, and wall climbing exercises are some of the recommended methods in a later stage. Now, acceptable level of angulation is less than 45 degrees of angulation, and displacement less than 1 centimeter is acceptable. About 80 to 85% of the proximal humeral fractures can be treated conservatively, conservative methods only. As far as the operative treatment is concerned, Hinton et al. Had published their paper, and in that particular research paper they advocate the rigid internal fixation of displaced fractures of proximal humerus in older patients with blade plate device, and this provides sufficient primary stability to allow the early functional treatment. We all know that if the shoulder is immobilized for long, it becomes stiff. So for that, Hinterman says, the restoration of the anatomy and biomechanics may contribute to the good functional outcome when compared with the alternative method of fixation and conservative method. They use the plate fixation. Now, regardless of the age, they advocated the primary open reduction and rigid internal fixation for all 3 and 4 part fractures. This depends upon whether the injury is 2 part, 3 part etc., or it's just a plain fracture or a fracture associated with the dislocation. So sometimes a primary arthroplasty is allocated. Highly comminuted part 4 fracture needs prosthetic replacement with the knees prosthesis. This was the original knees prosthetic design. And this is what is a post-operative radiograph showing a replacement using a knees prosthesis. Now, when the rotator cuff is irreparably damaged, then you need to go for a reverse shoulder arthroplasty. This particular radiograph shows a case of reverse shoulder arthroplasty. Now, the complications of proximal humeral fractures include the various complications. It can be summarized as follows. 1. Joint stiffness. Now, joint stiffness is due to periarticular fibrosis. 2nd is malunion. Malunion is due to various muscle forces we have already seen. Then 3rd is avascular necrosis is seen if the fracture is in the anatomical neck. And 4th, non-union of surgical neck fractures. And 5, the myositis ossificus due to vigorous massage and the treatment. Now, did you know that axillary nerve is the most commonly injured nerve in the proximal humerus fractures? And second important point nowadays, the internal fixation with intramedullary lock nail. Now this particular is the Polaris nail, where multiple holes, multiple direction you can interlock. And another is recent is the use of Phyllos plate, proximal humerus locking plate osteosynthesis, in the proximal humeral fracture is fast gaining moment. So this is all about the fracture shaft of the humerus, the proximal end of the humerus. I hope you can write a short note and a short essay using all this information. And before we end, I want to talk to you about one more important topic, and that is happy key to lose weight. Dear student, one of the commonest problem we are facing in our routine day-to-day orthopedic clinical practice is obesity. Now, to control obesity, the standard eat less and exercise more formula has proved to be a failed formula. Of late, I have been working on the latest, most scientific, evidence-based concept of the weight loss happy key. You may find few videos on this topic as well on my YouTube channel. The obesity among the medical students is at its peak nowadays. I see so many obese girls, medical students, and even the boys are obese, lot of obesity is seen. And due to obesity, not only they are bullied, but most of them also lose their self-confidence, resulting in deteriorating performance in their academics. That is what I am more concerned about. And for all of them, this online course will be most valuable. If interested, you may visit my Facebook page. I have given the link below. https://www.facebook.com/thehappykey. And you can visit my website www.drsudhir.com. You can also contact me on WhatsApp number, that is 7997168315. 16. Easy to remember. I host regular webinar for the same twice a week, that is on Wednesday and Friday evening 8 p.m. On Sundays, those who cannot attend on Wednesday and Friday for any reason, on Sunday the webinar is at 12 noon. You may join using the following link: https://zoom.us/j/82794043 08. So thank you for subscribing to my channel.